Sri Sukhendu Sekhar Roy,
sir,
your time is 6 minutes.
Sir, it appears that bamboo is not always desirable, but even though, I'll have to make my submission on this bill. First of all, when illegal felling of trees is going on unabated, this bill should not show the path of legal felling of trees. Once this bill is passed, it will open a Pandora's box, or it is open a new way for the illegal felling of trees. So government should ensure that this should not show the path of illegal felling of trees in the coming days. So now, this bill, before this bill came into place before this house, an ordinance was promulgated under Article 123. Now, Article 123 categorically states about the special circumstances. And I may be allowed to quote from Article 123. If, quote, if at any time, except when both houses of parliament are in session, the president is satisfied that circumstances exist which render it necessary for him to take immediate action, then this can be done. I am not questioning the satisfaction of the president, but I am questioning the objective of the government as to what was the circumstances necessary for promulgation of the ordinance. Because after a few days, because 23rd November this ordinance was promulgated, and in the first week of or second week of December, this house or and that house was supposed to be convened. But this time it has not happened. That is altogether a different thing. But why the government could not wait for some more time? What is the urgency? What was the compulsion on the part of the government? And I would request the Honorable Minister to clarify this position first, because otherwise the apprehension raised in different quarters, including the apprehension raised by Mr. Ramesh, I am inclined to share with his apprehensions, is there are certain other considerations. Now, because there, nothing has been said so far, I have gone through the press statement issued by the Honorable Minister, and it appeared on 23rd of November in different newspapers, and I quote one line or two lines. He says that this will now create a viable option for cultivation in 12.6 million hectares of cultivable wasteland. It will encourage farmers and other individuals to take up plantation, block plantation of suitable bamboo species, etc. Now, whether any study was made by the Environment Ministry about that, before the minister made this statement, whether any study was made by the ministry or not, if so, if at all any study was done, why it has not been informed to the nation, particularly the legislators? Because before promulgation of the ordinance, the ministry or the government should have told by a press statement, the way minister has issued the statement, that these are the considerations for which the government has decided to promulgate the ordinance. Because in plethora of cases, the Supreme Court has stated, ruled against promulgation of ordinances now and then. And in a recent case, the Supreme Court judgment in Krishna Kumar versus State of Bihar. In the case of Krishna Kumar versus State of Bihar, a seven-member bench of the Supreme Court has held that re-promulgation of ordinance is impermissible and termed it as a fraud on the Constitution, although it is not a case of re-promulgation. But even though in the same case, the Supreme Court has said that the Constitution does not permit the President or the Governor as a parallel lawmaking authority independent of legislature, because Parliament is the Supreme. Because the legislative power is with the Parliament and the legislatures. Now, sir, this is why I want to know from the Honorable Minister what was the urgency and exigency in promulgating the ordinance on 23rd of November. Because according to me, there was no compelling circumstances or exigencies so far the ordinance is concerned. Now, sir, so far the bill is concerned, the objective and reasons, it has been stated in the statement of objects and reasons. And I quote from the second paragraph, the farmers are facing hardships in getting the permits for felling and transit of bamboos within the state and also for outside the state, which has been identified as major impediment of the cultivation of bamboos by farmers on their land. I think, according to me, the word farmers should be replaced by the word traders, because traders or the corporates, actually those, they are actually facing hardship, not the farmers. Because nowhere in this country the farmers are getting any remunerative price. Although while initiating the bill, the Honorable Minister has said that this government is determined to increase the profit of the earnings of the farmers to the extent of 50% by 2022. They have to wait till 2022, and without knowing who will come in 2022, whether they will remain or any other party will come. But in the electoral promises, in the manifesto, they stated that for the farmers, they will ensure 50% profit over and above the cost of production. And 82 months have elapsed. And now the government is saying that you will have to wait till 2022. And in 2021, they will say you will have to wait for 2050. And this will go on. So this is an empty promise which has been established beyond doubt. Now, sir, I'm concluding. Only one point I would like to make, sir, from the bill. Why this bill is not important at all? Because if bamboo is cultivated in the land other than the forest, it is all right. But by this bill, the government takes away bamboo from the definition of the tree and definition of forest produce. In that case, we are going to convert a forest activity into a non-forest activity. This is my point. An exemption is sought for the bamboo grown in the forest area, because you are amending the definition of tree in the Forest Act. If this amendment is passed, no permit is required for felling and transiting bamboo as per the forest produce is required. Therefore, the government must have a relook to the bill and withdraw this bill in the interest of the forest community and the farmers as a whole.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you. Now, did you...